My name is Chris Christie. I'm the governor of New Jersey, and I'm proud to endorse Donald Trump for the next president of the United States. So, ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor and privilege to introduce to you the next president of the United States, Donald Trump.
Wow, this is some crowd. This is so. I love you. Thank you. Kentucky, we love Kentucky. Thank you very much, folks. This is amazing. What a turnout. We're having a good time. And I have one of my boys here. I have Eric. Does everybody know Eric? Come here. Eric has a lot of friends in Kentucky, and he said, can I go along with you? I said, yes. Say hello, Eric.
Wow. Well, hi, Kentucky. We are so proud of this man. I love him to death. He's been the greatest father to me. We are so proud of this. We are going to go all the way. We are going to win the White House. We are going to make America great again. Thank you.
He just got up here and he goes, wow, Dad, that's really a big crowd. You don't see it from here. By the way, are the Trump rallies fun? Is this the greatest? But the ex-president of Mexico used a filthy word that if I would have used it, I would have been run out of the country, right? He used it. Nobody said anything. But he wasn't so concerned about the wall. What he was really concerned about was nobody had ever spoken to them that way. Nobody said it's a one-way street and it's not going to happen anymore. And we said that. And the press said to me, Mr. Trump, he was very, very nasty. What do you have to say? I said, the wall just got 10 feet higher. Now, when it comes to trade, you've been reading a lot about Carrier, the air conditioning company. Last week, they announced that they are going to go to Mexico. They're going to close up shop. And they're going to Mexico. So here's what President Trump will do. I know it doesn't sound presidential, and I know I shouldn't be making this call, and I have the biggest business people in the world endorsing me, including Carl Icahn and others. But I know you might not like it, but I think you're going to love it, even though it really isn't presidential. I will call the head of Carrier, and I will say, I hope you enjoy your new building. I hope you enjoy your stay in Mexico. But you've just left the United States. There's no more taxes that you're going to pay. There's no more jobs that you're going to produce. 1,400 great people have been left out in the lurch. Here's the story, folks. Every single air conditioning unit that you build and send across our border, you're going to pay a 35% tax on that unit. All right, get him out. Get him out of here. Let me see that sign. I want to see that sign. Let me see. Hey, do me a favor. Hey, Corey, somebody, come here. Get me that sign. I want to see that sign. Thank you. Oh, I love you people. This is so incredible. And it's actually a very positive theme. Make America great again. Somebody said that's negative. It's very positive. Did you hear what Hillary said the other day? America, We're going to make it whole. What does that mean? We're going to make America whole. I think we'll use that in an ad. We'll put her left, me right. We'll make America whole. We'll make America great again, right? Isn't it crazy? Isn't it ridiculous? Okay, forget about those people. Forget about them. Get them out of here. Incredible. Incredible. All right. My whole life changed, and my whole campaign changed with Paris. Because Paris came in, oh, we have another wise guy. Go ahead. Get him the hell out. Get him out. Incredible. All right. Get him out of here. Go out. Get out. Get out. Get out. Yeah, don't hurt him. Don't hurt him. See, if I say, go get him, I get in trouble with the press, the most dishonest human beings in the world. The worst. If I say, don't hurt him, then the press says, well, Trump isn't as tough as he used to be. Can you believe this? So you can't win. Get him out of here. By the way, do we love our police? We have to give a hand to our police. We love our police. You know, in the old days, which isn't so long ago, when we were less politically correct, that kind of stuff wouldn't have happened. Today we have to be so nice, so nice. We always have to be so nice. They asked Ted Cruz at the debate, what do you think of waterboarding? And he's like a basket case. Well, because he didn't want to say yes because it's not nice. We have people chopping off our heads. We have people chopping off the heads of Christians and anybody else. And we're worried about waterboarding. We are going downhill fast. They then looked at me and they said, what do you think of waterboarding? I said, it's absolutely fine. We don't win. We lose at everything we do. We're an embarrassment. Our country is being laughed at by everybody in the world. Everybody takes advantage of the United States. Here's what's going to happen. We're all together. It's not me, it's us. We are going to go in. You're going to vote on Saturday. We are going to go in. And we're going to start winning so much. We're going to win with our military. We're going to knock the hell out of ISIS. We're going to win with our vets. We're going to take care of our great veterans. We're going to win with education. Right now, we're number 30 in the world. We're number 30, the bottom of the list. The top 30, we're the bottom of the list. You have Sweden and Denmark and Norway and China. We spend more per pupil than any other country by far, and we're at the bottom of the list. So we're number one in spending and number 30 in terms of the quality of education. Not going to happen anymore, folks. We're going to go up the list. People are going to respect our country again. I love you. We're going to win. We're going to win. We're going to win. We're going to make America great again. I love you. Thank you. I love you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, everybody. I love you. Thank you.